Good afternoon. I'm Dr. G.R.S.P. Silva, and I'm from District General Hospital, Nigambu. I thank you, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity to present our poster. As you all know, rabies is a neglected zoonotic disease which result fatal inflammation of the brain and the spinal cord. There are 20 to 30 people succumbing to human rabies annually in Sri Lanka. Therefore, our main objective of the study was to assess any gaps in the knowledge, attitude, and practices related to rabies and post-exposure prophylaxis among the patients presenting after animal bites to District General Hospital, Nigambu. It was a descriptive cross-sectional study. OPD and PCU in the hospital were the study settings. We recruited 400 participants by systemic random sampling and used pre-tested self-administered questionnaire during month of March to November 2020. We obtained the ethical clearance from the Faculty of Medicine, University of Kalyani. As to the results, there were 206 men. The male age was 35 years. Among the participants, 54.5% had PEDS, but out of them, 64.7% had done annual vaccination. 60.6% had vaccination cards. The reason for not vaccinating the pet were lack of knowledge of rabies and availability of free animal vaccination in the garment sector. The main type of bite was dog than cats. The site of bite more in legs than hands and other parts of the body. Most of the bites had took place mainly in their own houses and neighboring places than on the road. As you see in the tables, less than 50% had correct knowledge about rabies, infective agent, mode of transmission, preventive measures, and so on. But 85% had washed the wound immediately with any antiseptic despite of the place of bite. But as shown in the pie chart 1, only 67.5% of the participants had come to seek treatment immediately within few hours of the incident. 24.7% had come after few days. The main reason given for the delay was lack of awareness of the aftermath of the bite and lack of knowledge of rabies. Only 33.5% knew that what the PP, what the post-exposure prophylaxis is. 99% participants knew that anti-rabies vaccine could be given to anyone unless known allergies to the previous vaccination. Only 5% knew that the anti-rabies vaccine could be given to pregnant and lactating mothers. In the conclusion, our study showed overall knowledge, attitude, and practices related to rabies and post-exposure prophylaxis were considerably insufficient, and new strategies should be implemented to fill those gaps in order to achieve zero human rabies deaths by the year 2030. Thank you.